dominion over this area. Hallelujah. We have said that the chief and the what do you call that person na kizungu mtu ambaye amefanya tukakuja hapa. Wewe mwenye umesema tusimamie na tupige makofi with a standing ovation. Jesus, right? So the person that has orchestrated this meeting, that has caused us to be here tonight, that person is the person that has dominion over this place. Because we are here courtesy of him. We are under his authority. So when you say you are in dominion over something, it means that you have authority over that said thing. Hallelujah. So dominion is sovereignty and control over a certain thing or jurisdiction or area. Hallelujah. Hapo ndo sababu tunasema Ruto has dominion over what? Over Kenya. Because he is the president. He has authority. Naona jenzi wameanza kujishika. Wame smile hapo kidogo ni kama wako na tashwishi. Hiyo mambo tutaingia tukitoka kanisa. Saizi tuko hapa. Acha tu tuseme hivyo. Sawa? Calm down. Mimi sina maneno. Niko sawa. Hata ni usinifanye niseme mimi ni jenzi. Don't make me say that. But I'm saying under legal terms, according to the law, Ruto has dominion over Kenya because we voted him in and gave him power to be the chief commander general. Am I wrong, Lubang? I am right. Right? Thank you. I am right. Amekubali. Huyo akubalingi na nguvu. Kiona amekataa kuinua kichwa, amekubali. Huyo ameshasema yes. Hallelujah. Dominion is something that is inherently present in our gene as human beings. We can see this from the book of Genesis chapter 1 and verses 26 when God was creating man. God said, let us make man in our own image, according to our own likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth and everything creeping. Every creeping thing that creeps on earth. That means that God has given us dominion. Initially, let me say this because I know people will start questioning. You know, we have theologists, Pharisees. We have a rabbi in this congregation. He's outside, but he's a rabbi. He knows everything. He can give you Bibles mpaka na miaka. Yani unaona ukianza kusema mambo ya Esther, he knows the year na anakuambia hizo vitu 1860 BC na hizo mambo. Sasa anakuaga hatari sana. Lazima ukiongea uongee ukijichunga usiseme uongo. Ama usiseme kitu huko shua kwa sababu baada ya hapa atakuita kando na kuuliza sasa Buddha ulisema ati ni sasa kwa sababu sitaki maneno acha niseme vizuri. God, when he created man, he gave us dominion initially. That is in accordance to Genesis 1 and 26. And we see that over time man lost dominion over time when he transgressed and violated a law or a command that he had been given by God not to eat from the forbidden tree of life. So how did man lose dominion? When man took the fruit, we see that it was the woman who is still man. So when I say man, just understand I am still talking about the woman. You understand? So tuko pamoja hapo. So when the woman was beguiled by the serpent and took that fruit and partook of it, we see that the woman lost dominion. But because the man was the original creation of God when he began, it meant that dominion had not yet gone away. The woman had to take the fruit and present it to the man. Hallelujah. Who all of us know is the head of the family, right? So in order to topple a family, in order to coup, you call it a coup, ile ku overturn na ku overthrow familia, lazima u overthrow nani? Mwanaume. So the woman took the fruit to the man and said, you taste this thing, it is very sweet. And the man tasted. And when the man tasted, it says that immediately something about them changed. They noticed a specific change over their lives. They noticed, first of all, that they were naked. Hallelujah. And we see that as a result, you see now, first and foremost, the moment shame is introduced over your life, it means you have lost dominion over a certain jurisdiction of your life. I am just introducing slowly. I hope we understand. Now, what is the first sign that these people lost dominion is one, shame ile yenye tunaitanga na Kiswahili aibu ilianza kuwashika. Wakagundua kumbe sina nguo. Alafu cha kufanya mambo ikue worse, maybe aligundua hana six pack. Akasema ah, bibi yangu anaweza ona sina six pack. Unaelewa? Na mama akaangalia akasema ama sina hips, wacha tu nijifunike kwa sababu sasa aibu ishaingia. Unaona huyo jamaa ame lose authority because they are not confident of what they represent at that point in time. The first thing they resorted to doing was hiding away from the road, from the Lord, sorry, because the Lord is the main person that had given them dominion. You know, a person that gives you something, it means that that person is the custodian of that thing. That is why the Bible says in the book of Hebrews 7:7 that without any contradiction, the lesser will always be blessed by the greater. It means that the one that blesses is the one that has the authority. That is the one in control. So he decides, I am blessing Pastor Godfrey today. And as such, now, God that gave them dominion and made them in his own likeness, when they transgressed, they lost that dominion that was given to them. Hallelujah. So that is where man lost dominion, round one. Sasa tushaingia kwa penye tulipoteza. Tushajua kwenye tulipata na kwenye ilipotelea. Walakin, inasemekana kwamba hata kama walikuwa wamepoteza, kulikuwa na chembe kidogo ya kitu inakaa kama dominion kwa maisha yao. Sindio? We can see this in the book of Genesis chapter 11. That it gives us the story of a man called Nimrod Cush. Nimrod Cush was an excellent hunter of the old. The Bible says that in those days when men spoke one language, and you know they had one, when they say they spoke one language, it means they were in union. They were not speaking a different story. Their statements were one and the same. Media guy, I want you to, when I say Genesis 11, you drop it as I drop, because time is bad. You see, and the Lord, no, start with one first. Start with one, then we will go to six. But you're doing a good job. Metafoot, at a squash one is six, asante. Now the whole earth had one language and one speech. It means what they were speaking was in union. They were not speaking any contradictory statements. Now the whole earth, yes. And it came to pass that as they journeyed from the east, that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. So when they were journeying, it means they were moving together as one. Because when you are one block, when you are one entity, munatembeanga pamoja. That is why the Bible says that, and a man shall live his mother and father and shall go and cleave to his wife, and together they shall become one. Because once they become one, they assert a certain authority over what they represent. That is why Satan will quickly and always run to fight families, because he knows these people, once they become one union, there's a certain authority that they have. It means that whatsoever they agree, same as these people in the book of Genesis 11, there is nothing that can stop them from achieving that thing that they wanted to do. So as I continue, we see that these men decided that they wanted to build a city and a very tall tower that would reach the heavens of the earth, to a point where they would cement their names in the history of the world. It means that they would never be forgotten after they had done this. Hiyo inamaanisha kuna authority fulani, watakuwa kama principality. Hata after walikufa, hautawahi wasahau. Utakuwa ukiangaliaga hivi hiyo tower unasema, Pastor Godfrey na Mbogi walifanya hii kitu. Ushaelewa? But because their thoughts and their desires were contrary to the will of God and to the ordinances of God, it says that this thing that they were planning to do caught the attention of God. And now God had to come down and distract and distort their languages, because he says, since these men are united in this way, then there is nothing that can be kept from them. It means that a person or a people that are united, there is an authority they command, and there is nothing that can be kept from them. Long story short, it means that even as a church, if we speak one language and we are of one speech, there is a certain kind of dominion that we assert over the territory that we are in, and there is nothing that can be kept from us. There is nothing that we cannot achieve. Tuko pamoja paka hapo? Naona mnaniangalia kidogo ni kama nikianza kuongea vitu as make sense. Unafanya hivi. Fanya hivi. Nitaelewa na nita cancel mapema. Hallelujah. Sasa tuko paka hapo, tumeona. Bado Nimrod Kush. Jamaa me unite Mbogi na jamaa kona vision na kuna ka dominion fulani walikuwa anajaribu kufanya hapo, but Mungu akakuja akakatisha kwa sababu haikuwa inambatana na maono ya nani? Ya Mungu. Because God had commanded them to go and be fruitful and what? Fill the earth. The moment you decide that you want to remain in one place, in one city, it means you are violating the core command or instruction that God had given you. Go be fruitful and what? Fill the earth. So mkisha sema mnabaki Nairobi peke yake, ni earth gani unafeel? So mkisha sema wewe sasa umeshaji baptize, evangelist, apostle, prophet, mate, major one, lakini unataka tu zungukie umoja tu. Wewe ni transformation gani unafanya? Ushaelewa? You must aspire. Though yes, I know that dominion is territorial, especially when it comes to ministry. Kuna a certain jurisdiction that is given over a man. There are those that will be given villages. There are those that will be given cities. There are those that will be given nations. Yes. But if God has destined you to occupy a nation, yet you choose to settle for a village, is that not transgression? That is a sin, automatically. Yet, again, if God has given you a village to occupy, to make and bring impact in that village, and you choose you want to go to the nations, again, you are transgressing. So, it is important to know your area of authority and jurisdiction that you have command over, especially when it pertains to what? To ministry. Hallelujah. We are continuing. Tuangalie ko kitu hapo inaitwa Genesis 27 and verses 20. We are still talking about dominion. But now, I want us to speak a little more about dominion over time. Dominion over time. Because dominion is a broad aspect. But I feel that dominion, the greatest or the zenith of dominion is not dominion over things. Yes, we have been given dominion over cows, over these things that creep on the earth and all that. But if someone can manage to have dominion over time, it means that you have achieved the highest level of dominion. Because when you have time, all these other things that you seek to have dominion over will automatically fall under that category. Hallelujah. There's a famous saying that says that time waits for no man. It means that time is not a respecter of persons also. It does not matter if you are lazy. It does not matter if you are occupying your time. But time will always continue to move regardless of whether you are utilizing it or you are not utilizing it. Hallelujah. And we see that in the book of Genesis 27 and verses 20, Isaac, this is the story of Isaac when he was old and his vision had started to dim. He wanted to bless his sons. I bless the Lord for these kinds of scriptures because they remind us that as a disciple, as a believer, as a son of the light, we are not supposed to die like witches and these other lower class people. You understand? We are not supposed to die like dogs. Because these men of old, anytime their time was close to for them to go and be with their fathers, they always knew. And they always put their house in order. So this is Isaac. He has already noticed that time is moving. So he wants to bless his children so that he can depart from the world after he has put his house in order. To fulfill that scripture that says that a good man leaves an inheritance for his children. Because now, the first inheritance that you owe your child is a blessing from you. Imagine if you depart from this world, auja wachia mtoto baraka, hapo is a complication. So Isaac is about to bless his son. And when he is talking to his son, now this is Esau and Jacob. He's talking now to Esau and he tells Esau, go and bring me some wild meat. And then after I partake of it, I will bless you. And then the mother overhears what the father is saying to the son, but she runs again to Jacob and she tells Jacob, we can do this, we can do this, we can do this. Long story short, this is now Jacob approaching his father. And he comes to his father and he tells his father, I have done that thing. Nimekuja na nyama, sasa tukule. And the father says, how is it that you have found it so quickly, my son? How is it that you have found it so quickly? It means that Isaac in his long period of life had noticed that there is a process and there is a time it takes when a person goes for hunting. It is not that easy. It is not something that you go and then 10 minutes you come back. It is something that took time. So he was surprised that a few minutes, hours later after sending his son, he was already back. He had already cooked the meat and it was ready. Na nyinyi mnajua tu mambo ya zebra, simshakula punda nyinyi mnajua mambo ya punda. Aivangi rack. My assumption is, if it was wild meat, probably ilikuwa imekula shida na ilikuwa ngumu ngumu, si ndio? It took time to prepare. Kwa wale hamjakula punda, tushukuru Mungu na tunawaombea muendelee kukula tu hizi vitu za kawaida. Lakini kwa wale wamekula punda, semeni hai. Ni kama ni mimi nakulaga punda, nilikula punda peke yangu. Kwa hivyo sasa, Isaac anashangaa, how is it that you have found it so soon? But see what the son says to Isaac. The son says that because the Lord your God brought it to me. Hallelujah. The Lord your God brought it to me. So when Isaac asks, how is it that you found it so quickly? Avoid the lies. I know most of us, we want to focus on the part where they lie. But we are trying to draw a certain lesson from this situation. There is a reason, or the reason behind the speed with which the son had gotten the meat was because, one, he had been helped by God. It means that there is a way that God can help you to achieve certain things that have been rather away from you speedily. Kuna kitu unaweza faa ku achieve within 10 years under normal circumstances. You know, there's a way a person can come from a, before you struggle, you go to school, natoka na fees na nini, umalize, ndio uende, ndio hustle, ndio uanze kujenga nyumba, maybe you're supposed to be around 40. But instead, at 24, you already have a house. You see, that is, you have achieved something that is somehow contrary to the norm that we are used to. And I know most of you can bear witness that most people will say, oh, you are wash wash. Ushaelewa? Na siku hizi wakishindwa wash wash, watasema wa forex. Wakishindwa forex, watasema Illuminati. Zinakuwaga tu tatu. Hawakuwagi na nini, wanakuwaga tu na hizo tatu. How did you find? So the question is, how did you find out that secret so quickly? How did you achieve building so quickly? How did you get a job so fast? Some people have finished school. It's been 7 years, 8 years. They've not gotten a job. And it's a norm. They know. It's like in that field where I went to study from education. They know that once you finish school to become a teacher, unafas jungo je miaka tatu TSC, alafus jungo je kuplesiwa. So the earliest you can ever get a job is 5 years. And then when I emerge, 6 months, 1 year later, already, uko kazi. Ushaelewa. So someone will ask, but how? How did you come to this? How did you come to? It means there is a possibility in the dealings of God where people can have dominion over time. Hallelujah. I hope I'm making sense. Hallelujah. Destiny is measured as a function of time. Hallelujah. It is measured as a function of time. Meaning that whatever takes your time takes part of your destiny, and it also takes part of your life. It takes part of your life. Because hata ukiangalia maisha mtu, between the course of being born and the course of dying, they call it lifetime. It means that time is a function of life. So if you come to church and you are sleeping as early as 11, whose time are you wasting? You're wasting your time. That means you're wasting your destiny. That means you are tampering with your future. Because every second counts. Every second counts. Because destiny is a function of time. Everything that you do is a function of time. And Jesus and the Bible, let me just use the Bible, teaches us that under normal circumstances, time does not wait for a man. Time moves on. Time will tick. Whether you sleep, whether you wake up and read the Bible, whether you wake up and work hard, time will still continue. It just moves. It does not care if you are lazy. It does not care if you are tired. Time lost, it is lost. Once you come to today, and I know all of you, anything you did not do well yesterday, you cannot go back to yesterday to fix it. In as much as you want, in as much as you regret. That is why most people were getting frustrated to the point where now God had to speak to them in the book of Isaiah and told them that remember not the former things, nor consider the things that have already passed, because there is a new thing that God does. It means that after one thing has passed, the only thing you can do is look forward to something new. Praise the Lord Jesus. Unfortunately, we do not have unlimited time as, you know, humans. Our time is limited. Sisi atuna unlimited time. Life yetu ikona esabu imeshapigwa. And that is why Jesus was careful enough to tell us that I will do the works of him that sent me while it is still day. Because night cometh when no man can be able to work. It means that even Jesus, in his state as God, he understood that ikitu nisipofanya saa hii, iishe miaka tatu na nusu, sitaweza kuifanya tena. Ushaelewa? So he knew, I must strive. I must work hard. I must read the Bible, because we see in the book, in the Bible, there is a time when Jesus is 12 years old. He is still going to the synagogue and is learning the word of God, because he knows if I don't prepare now, by the time I'm 33, itakuwa imekatika, because time is limited. In the book of Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 and 16. The Bible says that, see then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. So this is Apostle Paul. He's still encouraging us to redeem our time. The word circumspect means accuracy. Redeem your time with accuracy. Because as it is, because time is limited on earth, you cannot afford to guess. You cannot afford to do guesswork with your life. Everything that you do must be accurate. But then again, we must admit that a man can lose a great portion of his life majorly as a result of demonic attacks, as a result of ignorance, as a result of carelessness. Demonic attacks can also waste your time as well. Hence, there is this concept called delay. Delay. Hallelujah. I want us to define delay even as we continue. I'm almost done. Don't worry. Niko karibu kumaliza. Delay means that time has gone ahead of you in comparison to the accomplishments and the achievements that should happen within that time. Delay means that time gone ahead of you versus the accomplishments and the achievements that you are supposed to achieve within that time. There's a way I used to plan, and I wish my cousin was around, Hussein, he would have told you. We used to say, I get to 22, I buy a car. I get to 24, I marry a beautiful wife. I get to 28, I have two children, take them to international school. You understand? By that time, I have a mansion in Karen. Just so you know, by that time, I have a mansion in Karen and a few cars here and there. I had even Googled a few. I knew which brands I want. You understand? My wife is here. She can bear witness. I married a beautiful wife. I thank God. That one I achieved. Cha. Tick. By 28, I had children. Tick. Lakini hapo kwa car. Hapo kwa house. Jesus. Eh? Hapo kwa Karen. Bado na covet. Ana kukuja nayo lazima baby utaishi Karen. Eh, na bedroom itakuwa kiwanja. Bedroom itakuwa kiwanja. Utakuwa unatembea, unatembea. Niaminie tu. Unanijua? Unanijua. Hivyo ndio nilimwambia paka akakubali nimuoe. Niambia wewe. Ile vitu nitakufanyia bwana. You will not believe. So you see, that's the way you have a plan. But now, delay is when that timeline that you were supposed to achieve that plan ishapita, lakini zile achievements na accomplishments yenye ulifaa ufanye bado haujafanya nini? Haujamaliza. Sasa hiyo ndio tunaita delay. Sasa hapo ndio tunapata hiyo concept, hiyo kitu inaitwa speed. Inaingilia hapo. Inaingilia wapi? Inaingilia hapo. Na speed is defined as the ability accelerated accomplishment within to achieve accelerated accomplishment within a short period of time. The ability to achieve accelerated accomplishments within a short period of time. That means for you to say you have speed, your accomplishments must outweigh your time, the time allocated. Shaelewa? Sasa hapo ndio tunasemanga uko na speed. Let me give you a good example. A good example is by the end of this year, 6 months, my wife is still saying she believes in me kabisa, na hata mimi najiamini na naamini Mungu. Sasa mwisho wa mwaka ni kweli nimepata at least ako kanyumba ka Karen, tu gari tuwili, na nimejenga kanyumba ama nimenunua. That is what? Speed. Because it is something that I have achieved, accrued, something that should have taken me 15 years, I have done within 6 months. That is now speed. Because the accomplishments outweigh the time that I have been given. Hallelujah. A barren woman who has been married for 7 years, has no children, but on her 8th year, she gets pregnant and she conceives triplets. Or quadruplets. Nilisikia mtu alithreaten juzi anataka kuza quadruplets in my presence. I almost fainted. Lakini nashukuru sio bibi yangu. Kwa sababu tayari niko na watatu. Sasa akiniwekea wengine wanne. Si watashanga. Watasema nimeanza nasari. Hapo inabidi nifungue shule. Elder Nancy uta au wajukuu wote utaweza? Ama atakushinda? Kama wewe unasema sasa acha basi nitajaribu. Kama Elder Nancy amesema anaweza, ni sawa. So you see, those 3 children, they are not children. They are a testament that God can bring speed over a man's life. Because mimi nimejikazakaza over 7-8 years, I have brought 3 children. And then this woman comes from nowhere within 8 years, nikifikiria nimemshinda, anakuja anachapa 3 na tunatoshana. So now I cannot again brag and say I am very far. The Bible says that Elijah, after speaking to Ahab and telling Ahab that the rains are coming, he guards up his loins, he runs and he overtakes even the chariots of the king, and he arrives in the city prior to the king. That is speed, because a person that is running barefoot and he runs faster to the point where he gets to where he needs to go before the chariots. That is speed. It is the same. Let us use a common example. Walking to town from here. For those of you that have not walked to town, I want to remind, also just let me interest you to know that also even me, I have walked to town several. My wife can bear witness. This body, the way it is formed like this and in shape, it is because of these hardships that we have hit here and there. I used to walk to town. I remember when we used to live in Embakasi. Banana bounce. 10 bob. Kupanda tu hapa forward hapa doni. 10 forward ilikuwa 10 bob paka mudhuru. Hakuna. Unaingia mguu. Alafu unapiga huko mradi unapata jioni uko na so. Sasa hii so unajiuliza. Nikisema nipande gari ya 80. Na babe amekaa huko anajua bazua alienda kuhaso. Unasema bana. Acha tungojengoje kagiza kaingie, unajua hey, watu wanaweza shangaa hawa maboys wanakoga wanakambe wako mbele. So tulikuwa napima kagiza kakiingia 7, tunaingia kwa barabara. Tunatembea. And then even up to now, somebody just give a mighty hand clap for our parents. Thank you, Baba. We love you. I was just telling them you are an important person. Kwa sababu tulikutana pipeline. Na wewe unaweza sema ni ukweli. Hawa wanafikiria ni uongo. I met this my father in pipeline in 2017. Again, you know, we used to go to high school together, but I met him in pipeline. That is a story for another day. But we met in pipeline kwa single. Anajua, Mama Magidon, karibu sana. Nakupenda. Na wasikuambie sikupendi hawa watu wanakuaga na maneno. Mimi, I love your ministry. It blesses me. So just know the first person here that values you is me. And then followed by them. If they don't clap, just know it is only me. Are they clapping? Nashukuru Mungu, sio mimi peke yangu, tuko wengi. Hallelujah. So as I was saying, walking to town would take you roughly about 2 hours. I used to take about 2 hours, 1 hour, 40 minutes. Kama nimetembea haraka vizuri. You cannot compare that versus going to town with a car. If you're going to town with a car or a motorbike and there's no traffic, you use roughly 5 to 10 minutes, right? So unaona, speed ya kutembea na speed ya gari ni tofauti. Yet Elijah managed to run far and faster than even that chariot, which was the modern day car for that time. So men can have dominion over time. Hallelujah. You can have dominion over time that men will look at your life and see absolute rest. They will see that you are not moved by any situation. It does not matter what you're going through at that time. You are not moved. You are not worried because you know there is something, there is a secret you know in God that has given you dominion over this thing called time. Hallelujah. May the Lord give you dominion over time. May the Lord give you speed. Let everything that has not worked out for you, everything that has been delaying in your life, may the Lord change that pattern in your life tonight in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say, I'm believing, amen. You know, you should come before God with expectation. You cannot deny yourself sleep and then come here and then you don't have expectation. You must say, God, because I have denied myself, or am I the only one that creates those conditions when I come? We discuss with God first. I say, because now I could be sleeping, but I have denied. Sasa Mungu, nikikuja, ikitu anasema dominion, kesho asubuhi, inafaa nikuwe na iona pia mimi kwa maisha yangu. Kwa hivyo, akisema tu, may the Lord, na kwa God number one, our father taught us, because this is a prophetic church, alisema, anything that looks like a prophecy that affects your life or may affect your life in future, grab it, take it, keep it in your pocket, live with it, use it. Because you don't know tomorrow if you will get a chance to say amen over these things that are causing delays over your life. Hallelujah. So may the Lord give you speed in life. May the Lord give you speed in life. That job that you have been looking for 7 years, 3 years, 2 years, 6 months, you're not seeing any change in your life. May the Lord grant you speed. Let that thing that has taken others 10 years to achieve, let the Lord bring it within achievement in your life in less that time than that. Amen. It is possible. Amen. It is possible. We are not preaching what we are guessing. This is not the theoretical. We are preaching what we have seen. And I believe that if I and my wife and my children saw that, also you can see it. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the things that were written aforetime were for our own learning and improvement. It means that everything that we learn in the presence of God, it should serve to change your life. It should serve to lift you to greater heights. Hallelujah. Situsimame na tushangilie Bwana. Oh Jesus, we thank you. Thank you so much for your wisdom. Just thank God for the wisdom. Thank him for what he has done up to this point in this Kesha. Thank him for what is coming ahead. I know the Spirit of the Lord is in this place tonight and there is liberty. there is liberty and there is change that has come, and tonight we are going to experience that change. So just go before God and say, thank you for what you have done. Thank you for your word that you have just released. Thank you for the seed that you are planting within me as a preparation for what you are about to do, Jesus. Thank you for the sessions that are oncoming. I pray that, Father, you will show your hand mighty over my life. I declare and decree, Lord, by the unction and power of the Holy Ghost, that I am regaining, I am repossessing that dominion that you set for me, Father. I am taking it back tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Tomorrow I will testify. Tomorrow I will walk over authority. Tomorrow I will possess my possessions. That which has been out of reach, Father, I declare by the end of this night, my Lord, I will have it in my camp again in the mighty name of Jesus. I worship you and I glorify your name, for you are worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus, for the lives you have loosed. Thank you for the destinies you have aligned. Thank you, Jehovah Father, for the seeds that you have planted, the revivals that you have caused in our spirits tonight. Continue to be lifted, continue to be magnified. Thank you for the sessions that are oncoming. We pray that you will continue to show yourself mighty over us tonight for the glory and honor of your name. I have prayed. Amen and amen. Somebody give a mighty hand clap to Karibu sana, Pastor Godfrey.
Thank you so much. Celebrate the Lord, celebrate the Lord. Now celebrate Pastor Evans, Pastor Imbiru, for blessing us. He's been a blessing to us. May the Lord refill you. Thank you so much for speaking into our lives, Pastor Evans. Hallelujah. Amen. We can descend to the comfort of our seats.